Our last and most awaited speaker this evening is His Excellency Dr. Karan Singh, who has one of the longest association with our Mandir and has been an ardent admirer of Dadaji since 1950. Dr. Karan Singh was the main speaker during Dadaji's centenary celebration in 1996 and was chosen by Ma to do so. I consider it is a great privilege to welcome Dr. Singh again on stage today to celebrate Ma's centenary.
After that beautiful speech by Hema, I think that what I say will lack that Bharatanatyam dimension. But let me begin first of all by paying homage to Dilip Da, because Dilip Kumar Roy played a very major role in my life. It was through him that I met four of the most important persons in my life. First of all, of course, he wrote a book called Among the Great. And in that book, there were interviews with five different people: Bertrand Russell, Romain Rolland, Rabindranath Tagore, Mahatma Gandhi, and Sri Aurobindo. That was the first time that I heard about Sri Aurobindo. And I wrote to him, I wrote to Dilip Da about that. And he sent me his second book, Sri Aurobindo Came to Me, which contained a whole chapter about Sri Krishna Prem, who was, as you know, an Englishman who had settled in Mirtola beyond Almora, and it was a beautiful ashrama. And he and his disciple Sri Madhava Ashish, they lived there. It was a Vaishnava ashrama set up by Yashoda Mai some time ago. And through this book, I came to know Sri Aurobindo, and the mother, Sri Aurobindo, had of course passed away, but I've seen him in my dreams. And I had the privilege of meeting the mother. I later did my PhD on Sri Aurobindo. That's how I got closer and closer to the Aurobindo movement, thanks to Dilip Da. And also Sri Krishna Prem and Sri Madhava Ashish, who were my Vaishnava gurus, with whom I had a very long association. So Dilip Kumar Roy was one of the most lovable people I've ever met in my life. His lovely songs, Tune kya kiya mujhe bata to sahi, mera chain gaya, meri neend gayi, meri hosh gayi, meri aap gayi, Tune kya kiya mujhe bata to sahi. And we always used to tease him because he kept saying, mera hosh gaya. Main kata, it's not mera hosh gaya, it's meri hosh gayi. He said, how can that be? Yes, Bengali mein to mera hosh gaya hoga. Main kata, Bengali mein, Hindi mein meri hosh gayi kehna padega aapko. So it was a very lovely song. Dhoondne tujhko jaamu kahan nahi milta hai, tera naam o nisha, meri umr talash mein sari gayi, chain gaya, meri neend gayi. Milna ho to aakar jald milo, nahi behre khuda mujhe qatl karo, chhoote ranjo bala se ye jaan meri, mera chain gaya, meri neend gayi. Tune kya kiya mujhe bata to sahi, mera chain gaya, meri neend gayi. So such a glorious thing. And he sang it for me all the time. Whenever I met him, he would specially sing it for me. I remember at John and Bim Bissell's house, the episode that was mentioned, I was there, I heard him there. He and Indira ji came twice to my house. They sang there. I was also singing with him. I heard him once in Haridwar. It was such a joy. I've never met a man like that, so full of love. And also Sri Krishna Prem was also suffused with the love of Sri Krishna. They were most extraordinary people that I've had the privilege of meeting. And Indira ji was always there with him. We used to speak in Punjabi because that was something which she always enjoyed doing. And I was reading her poems. It is quite extraordinary how she became one with Meera. More or less, it was as if Meera entered her consciousness, and the poems that she had composed were really contemporary Meera poems. You know, it's very difficult to make a distinction between which are Meera's poems and which are Indraji's poems, because she was so suffused with that. And Sri Aurobindo has written, that book is not with me, he has written that this sort of thing does happen, that on the occult plane, these higher personages, they enter people who are living and become, jaise Hema ne bataya, when she dances, she becomes Durga, because you have the consciousness of Durga in you. When you play Lakshmi, you know, each one of the goddesses have their own beauty. In Durga, it would be Durga Smita Harsi Bhiti Mashesh Janto Swaste Smita Mati Mati Shubham Dadasi Daridra Dukha Vahari Nikata Danya Sarvopakar Karanaya Sadartha Chitta. And if you're playing Lakshmi, Yasa Padmasanastha Vipulukatitati Padma Patraya Takshi Gambhira Vartana Bhistana Bharanmita Shubhravastrottariya Lakshmi Divyahi Gajendrihi Manigana Khachitihi Snapita Hema Kumbhehi Nityam Saha Padmahasta Mamo Vasudu Grahe Sarva Mangalya Yukta. So these Sanskrit, particularly Sanskrit connected with Bharatanatyam, to my mind is the most divine manifestation on this earth. There can be nothing that takes you closer to the divine than to have a Bharatanatyam dancer, somebody like Hema, and you have these great Sanskrit shlokas, and the deities become alive in front of you. So unlike the Greek gods, our gods are still alive. I am a worshipper of Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is there. Sri Krishna is there. All the goddesses are there, as long as we are able to approach them. But we have got to become them, as he rightly said. Unless we keep ourselves open to the divine vibrations, we cannot really realize them. So I do not want to take much of your time. We had a very interesting academic lecture by the Sanskrit professor. We had some lovely music. We had a very nice speech from Hema. And I'd like on this occasion to pay my homage to Dilip Kumar Roy, who was like an elder brother to me, and to Indira ji, who was like a sister. And on, I can't believe that she would have been 100 today. I mean, how time flies. I remember 50, 60 years ago I met her first, 60 years ago. Or even 70 years, 60 years ago I met her. And she was there vibrant, and her love and her eyes and the devotion that she had. But to see her and Dilip Dar together was really a glory. Because two human beings were so full of love and adoration for the divine. So I will congratulate the organizers for giving us the opportunity to pay our homage to these two great souls. I thank the professor for her lecture and Hema for her very nice speech. And I'll end with a prayer to Sri Krishna, because they were all Krishna Bhaktas. There's a beautiful prayer which says to Sri Krishna, okay, please take us into your consciousness today, because when the final moment comes, we may not be able to speak. We do not know where we will be. We may be in an ICU. So the prayer is, do not wait for that time, take me today. Krishna todiya padapankaj panjarante adeva me vishatu manasa rajahamsaha pranaprayana samaye kafavati pittehi kanthavarodhana vidhau smaranam kutas. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for your gracious presence and such inspiring. Please be here for 1 minute.
Okay, yes,
I won't get this. Please. And I now request Jagannath Chakravarti to please come up on stage and honor His Excellency Dr. Karan Singh.